Guys, what's up? I hope you are doing all right and keeping safe, considering the Rona hasn't left town yet. So yeah. Welcome to my channel, to my vlog, to welcome to my hood, to my old. If you haven't subscribed yet, I don't know what you're waiting for, because I'm your surest plug for everything style, especially turbans. Scroll down, like you'll see something you really, really like and would learn from. Apart from that, I'm your surest plug for skincare, especially for acne prone skin. Disclaimer though, I'm not a dermatologist, neither am I an esthetician, neither am I a skin therapist. I'm just someone who's battled acne in her 20s, her early teens, and early adulthood at the moment, as I'm approaching my mid 20s now. And I just want to share my experience with the S in brackets with a lot of people in my age group who might be experiencing this. And yes, if you are also a lazy naturalista, you might want to subscribe. You might want to subscribe, beg your pardon, to my channel. See my hair. Yeah, and I made this myself, guys. Look. If you want the video of this thing, I did not upload it too. I didn't do that. I didn't even record while I was doing this, because this took me almost the whole day. But yeah, that aside, let's just get into what I'm going to talk about today. I've already put out a disclaimer. I'm not a dermatologist, neither am I an esthetician, neither am I a skin therapist. I just want to be honest with you guys about battling acne and what you should do when battling acne. There's some mistakes I made in the past, and I wish I knew those things before now, because I believe if I had known those things before now, my acne story would have been a little less worse than it is. But because I was going with the crowd, you know, moving with the crowd, and that's what a lot of us do. Now, the very first thing, the number one thing I will tell you is, if you have one breakout, it's okay. It could be stress, it could be hormones, it could be lack of sleep, because these are contributing factors to acne. But when you have an army of pimples on your face, when you have an army of pimples, you know that this is serious business. Your first resort should be a certified, in quote, a certified dermatologist. Not Google. You know why? Because to tackle your acne problem, the first thing you need to know is what kind of acne you have. And this can only be determined by a certified dermatologist. If and when you go to Google, you might get some informative suggestions about what your acne is about, but it might not give you a definite, it might not really define your acne, which means that you would just be wasting money on a lot of products which would not work for you. So I hope you can see the reason why I strongly recommend that your first resort should be a certified dermatologist and not Google. It saves you a lot of money. It saves you a lot of time. It saves you, it gives you the confidence knowing that, okay, I'm on track. Not inside, let me use that phrase, because you're testing this, you're trying that, you're experimenting. No, this time you're not experimenting nothing. You're going to a dermatologist and they would be the one to examine your acne and tell you this is the kind of acne you have and this is what we should do to tackle it. You can spend 50,000 naira on skincare products that would not work for you simply because you haven't determined the kind of acne that you have yet, because you haven't gone to see a dermatologist. Yes, I know seeing a dermatologist could be expensive, nothing less than 20,000 to 30,000 naira max at most. I mean, I haven't paid more than that to see a dermatologist. So I'm telling you out of my own experience and testimony, the least you can pay for consultation with a dermatologist or skincare or an esthetician is, I think, 10,000 naira in Nigeria. I'll convert it to dollars. You'd say it's on here. I'll do that. So look, just save yourself time, stress and energy and go to a dermatologist first. Trust me, that is a lot more cost effective than wasting money on products and testing this, if it works, testing that, to see whether it works or doesn't work. Number two, skins are different. You should know that. So one might take Mr. A or Ms. A 10 months to clear up, might take you longer. Just know that. Three, your diet is very important. There are a lot of things that are contributing factors to acne. Dairy, fats, a lot of oil, lack of sleep, just a couple lot of things. So you need to also put these things in check. Balance your life. Exercise is also very, very important. Your blood, there needs to be circulation of blood in your body, especially around your face, to boost collagen production, which is automatically like what your skin needs to produce new skin, not melanin. Now melanin is the pigment that makes your skin dark, that gives me this brown skin you can see that I'm blessed with. So yes, you need to exercise, you need to eat well, you need frequent visits to the dermatologist, you need to make sure that you have a napkin that you wipe your face with, but make sure it's clean napkins. Also have wipes, very, 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 very handy. Okay, have wipes. Do not pick or prick your pimples. If there's anything at all that I know has helped me in my acne journey, is not pricking my pimples. If you look very well, my scars are not very, very pronounced. This is because when I had multiple breakouts, I still experience breakouts, by the way, when I had an army of pimples on my face, I disciplined myself. Look, it takes a lot of discipline and courage not to use your hands, not to use your fingers, just prick something. Look, I know how hurting pimples can be, especially the ones on your forehead and your chin or somewhere around your lip. If you've ever had a pimple on your lip, then you know how hurting it can be. Okay, but discipline yourself not to pick your pimples. It would help you. It would help you. But that doesn't mean that you shouldn't go see your dermatologist. Okay? Another thing I think that helped me in my acne journey, or one thing I wish I ever knew before now was how very important sunscreen is to your skincare routine. Not just sunscreen, toner. To be very honest, I started using toners February this year. And let me be real with you 100. This is July, February, March, April, May, June. Okay, let me just give it 5 months since it is just the 5th of July, right? I wish I know how important toners are in skin. Man, since I started using toners in my skincare, there has been a visible difference in my skin tone. My pores have visibly reduced. My face feels smoother. It feels softer. I just wish I knew this before now. Google didn't tell me that. Google didn't show me that, you know. And that's what I'm telling you. It is not everything you see on Google that is valid. And you may not find the right information for you on Google. Just like I've heard a couple of people say that when you start feeling some type of way in your body, go see your doctor. Don't go to Google. Google can kill you. Did I just say that? I didn't mean it that way. Look, what I meant was you can find some information on Google which might be helpful, but it may not be what it really seems. Okay? That's what I'm trying to say. It may not be what it really, really, really seems like, right? So Google didn't tell me, oh, I'm supposed to do this, oh, I'm supposed to do that. And when I started using toners, like, there was so much difference. And I thought, oh, I wish I really knew this before now, you know? Another thing was sunscreen. I didn't even know the importance of sunscreen. I think the reason why I began to know these things was how intentional I decided to become with my hair and skin this year. Like 2020, I told myself, okay, you know what? I'm going to be intentional about my hair and skincare routine. I'm going to get better at these things, okay? So I think being deliberate is even one thing you need to know about skincare and hair care. But since we're talking about skincare, I'm just going to stick to skincare in this case. When you're battling acne, you need to be very intentional about it. Do the right things, eat well, sleep well, make sure your space is clean. Because another thing is, you could get acne from your pillowcases, so making sure everything your face comes in contact with is clean can never be overemphasized. Your phones, your earphones, your glasses, like mine.
Okay, I see, why is the light on?
Oh, I'm here. Sorry, that was my sister. So, all of that, you know, what was I saying? Making sure your light. I got distracted now. So, making sure that whatever your face comes in contact with is clean can never ever be overemphasized. Okay, change your pillowcases once every week. Clean your phone. Clean your gadgets every day. Basically, clean your gadgets every day. Most importantly, wash your hands before touching your face. Let me give you an example. If you just came out of the bathroom and somebody calls your phone and you use your finger to slide and pick that call, before touching your face, go back to the bathroom, wash your hands before touching your face. There could be bacteria on that phone which can transfer to your face, mix with whatever sebum is on your skin and transform into a pimple overnight. Yes. So you see, make sure your hands are clean all the time before you do anything or before you apply anything to your face. Okay. So with this very few points, I just hope I've been able to enlighten you about doing the right things and being intentional, really, really intentional about your skin. Okay. Just bear it in mind that you cannot treat your acne if you don't even know what kind of acne you have. It's not just possible, dears. So yes, make that decision today. Book your appointment with your dermatologist today. Meanwhile, if at the moment you cannot afford a dermatologist, I'm going to put up another video of how I manage my acne in a cost effective way before I could afford a dermatologist. I mean, if you're in your teens or 20s or early 20s and you do not have any source of income and you're totally dependent on your guardian or someone older, I can understand how do you see that 30,000 naira is a lot of amount of money to just go and give somebody. But hey, so yes, I'm going to upload another video on how I managed my acne in a cost effective way for a while before I even started seeing my dermatologist this year, you know, because I couldn't afford one in the previous years, or I was just I just thought using or trying different things were cheaper than seeing a dermatologist. But now that I have seen one, trust me, seeing a dermatologist is way, way cost effective. Like, it is way cheaper than wasting your money on different skincare products that may not even end up working for you. So yes, if you learned one or two things, please do leave a comment. If you have any questions, do feel free to ask in the comment section them. I'll do justice to them. Please like this video, subscribe, and most importantly, share with someone you know maybe needing this. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.